So you're trying to figure out what degree you should be doing now that you are ready to go to college. And the easiest way to decide this is, what do you want to be maybe 20 years from down the line? So I graduated with my electrical engineering degree. And before I went into my degree, I went through a list of different degrees that I was interested in. And I knew what I wanted to do toward the ender part of my life. And a lot of those things that I want to do later on requires a lot of funding. And I cannot go to school and get an art degree and hope that I can cover all these expenses or be able to afford all of these real estate. It's possible, but it's, you know, the chances of that are very, very slim. And I'm not trying to battle that right now. So if you're in that position right now, you don't know what to pick, ask yourself, do you want to be able to take care of a family? Do you want to be able to take care of your parents when they get old? Do you want to be able to afford a house in your lifetime? Because these answers, a lot of people cannot answer that. A lot of people cannot afford to raise a family. A lot of people cannot afford to help their parents when they get old, or because some parents don't have a 401k. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit the like button and the subscribe button. And I really want to hear what you guys think about this subject matter down in the comment section down below. This is just the reality of life. And a lot of people die without ever owning a house. Not because they don't want to, it's because the chess pieces that they played in their life played out not in their favor. So now that you know this, you're trying to find a degree that will reward you massively. So my theory, my goal is, if you're gonna get a degree, you should be able to pay off that degree within 1 year of you working that job. So let's say you went to University of Texas and you got a $60,000 loan to finish your 4-year degree as a school teacher. Honestly speaking, there's a high chance that you'll never be able to pay that off for your whole life. So you'll always have that chain around your neck till the day you die, paying off 60 grand off of your student loans. And because once you graduate, you know, let's say you get married, you have kids, you're probably gonna be paying the minimum for your student loan so that you can take care of your current life. It becomes very, very hard to get out of this prison. But if you go on the higher end of things, there's degrees in health, there's degrees in STEM that can help you have a higher insurance for those things. But even so, if you did art, if you did business, perfectly fine. You can still be debt free if you play your cards right. So if you're gonna if you're going to college, you don't know, be sure you pick a degree that will cover what you need to cover. A lot of people go to college being selfish, only thinking about myself. Let me go do what I enjoy. Let me go do what I like. Okay? That's fine. Nobody's gonna stop you. But you just gotta remember, whatever, you're only thinking about yourself. When you add people into the picture, it may get a little difficult to do what you wanna do. So that's what I wanna share with you. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button and the subscribe button. And tell me, what do you think in the comment section below? What do people need to know or understand to make sure that they get a degree that works for them?